What's the safe use of an iodine nasal spray? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Herb Simmons says, how frequently can you safely use an iodine nasal spray, and how long would each set of sprays likely protect you from corona? So the iodine in the food and supplement guide for the coronavirus, most recent version I included, iodine is a nasal spray. important. It's very important to look at the percentages. And so 0.5% is the concentration recommended. And that means that if you get a 10% solution, which is the most common one, you want to dilute it down 20-fold, which means taking one part of the 10% solution, 19 parts water. If you have a different percentage starting solution, you want to dilute it differently. And it's critically important that you dilute it properly. And so you should have someone double check your work if you're doing your own math, or triple check your work, because higher concentrations can cause damage to the nasal tissue. But in terms of how often, so what I recommend doing is using it as a before and after in potential exposures. As I mentioned before, when I was talking about the zinc acetate lozenges, I would define that differently depending on whether you're in an area of active outbreak. So when New York was the epicenter of the disease and there were 40 ambulances passing by my apartment in a day, I considered going outside among people in any context to be a potential exposure. Now I consider unusual intermittent exposures to crowds to be potential exposure, especially if I'm going outside of my normal daily context, especially if I'm going to a place that's either out of state or where I expect many people out of state to be traveling to. And so in that sense, I'm not doing potential exposures very often. So if you're in somewhere where you still have the caseload increasing and it hasn't started reversing, then I would consider doing this, you know, up to once a day before and after you go out to do something. If I was in a place where the caseload was steadily increasing in one of the, you know, several states, I wouldn't be going out among people that often. I would be, you know, doing what I need to do and being kind of efficient about it and then waiting for the caseload to start going down. I don't think it's clear yet whether it's going down anywhere because of herd immunity or lockdown measures or mask wearing. I think there's so much unknown that I would rather not go into a crowd than use the povidone iodine and the zinc acetate and all the other stuff five times a day because I'm always going out into crowds. So if you're using it twice a day because you have to go out every day and you're in an area of active outbreak, then I think that's fine to do until the outbreak settles in your area. I wouldn't worry about it. But I wouldn't use more than you need to in terms of the milliliter amount. You know, I wouldn't use a... if you can get a rinse through your nose, I wouldn't try to get it cycling through your nose 30 times. You just want to use the minimal amount you need to get into your nose. That lasts 10 minutes. So this is not a thing where you take it in the morning to protect you all day. This is a thing where, oh, I'm going to the grocery store, very crowded in there. Cases are increasing out of control in my area. I don't know when they're going to reverse. I don't know who in the grocery store has corona. So I'm going to rinse the nose when I go there. I'm going to come back and immediately rinse the nose after that. I'm going to wait 10 minutes before I eat or drink anything. That's the limit of it. Yeah, you can overdose on it if you're doing it excessively, but if you're doing it on the basis that there's a temporary spike in COVID in your area that will reverse, and you're limiting it to two rinses a day on the basis that you're only trying to protect against these potential exposures, then I don't think that it's anywhere near the range where you would have to worry about doing it too much. Now, granted, you might have an unknown allergy to povidone iodine or something like that, so it's not without concern. But I don't think overdosing on the iodine is a concern in that context. All right, Herb, I hope that helped. Thank you very much for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.